Today, I'm going to show you how you can reinforce your 3D prints with steel and how much stronger they will become. To start, we of course need some steel. And in order to keep things simple, we are going to use steel wire. This is stranded wire with a total diameter of 1 mm. The basic idea is to cut out paths inside your 3D model. Your slicer is then going to add additional perimeters around it, and therefore creates a foundation in which you can press the steel wire with the help of a soldering iron during the print. Additionally, the path guides the steel wire, so it's really easy to align it. I am going to explain this with more detail later in this video, but before that I want to answer the most important question. Does this even work? For that I have modeled 3 different test parts. While on the first one, the forces will pull in the same direction as the wire is oriented inside the part, the second one will test a bending situation, and the last one combines pulling and bending. I printed the test parts with clear PETG, and both the reinforced and non-reinforced parts have used the exact same G-code. I also quickly put together this test rig. It's basically just a threaded rod, which, if I turn it, will pull on the test sample. A crane scale then shows the force applied to the part. And just to be clear, in this video I'm going to use kilogram as a unit of force. I think it's just more appropriate to do so in this case, but if you don't feel comfortable with that, just multiply all the values with 9.81 to get the forces in the unit Newton. Alright, here comes the fun part. The reinforced bend and pull test parts both have an increase in strength of more than 50%, the combined test part of more than 100%, compared to the plastic only parts. Interestingly, the combined test part was the part with the least amount of wire loops inside. It might be an interesting topic for a future video to see how the amount of wire inside a part influences the strength of it. Even though I would take the exact numbers of all these measurements with a grain of salt, I think it's safe to say that embedded steel wire does have a positive effect on the strength of 3D printed parts. However, keep in mind that this technique only improves strength in the X and Y direction, and depending on your part's geometry, might work better or worse. But this shouldn't stop you from at least trying to reinforce your parts, as it's really easy to do. Let's say we want to reinforce this part right here. Currently, it is completely solid. I would like to add one layer of wire, so I create an offset plane and position it right into the middle of the part. Next, I create a sketch and project the outlines. I create an offset to those outlines and set the distance to a multiple of the extrusion widths of my 3D printer. This isn't necessary, but it will ensure that we are getting some nice perimeters around our steel wire. Next, I add another sketch and create a rectangle with its center right on the path we created before. The edge length is set to roughly the diameter of our wire. Lastly, I sweep this profile along one of the paths we created in the sketch before. After doing the same thing for the other two paths, the part is ready for slicing. I am going to show you how to process that part in Simplified 3D, but any other good slicer should work similar. First, you want to check the number of the layer which is going to be printed right on top of the steel wire. In this case, it's layer number 13. Now we only have to add some G-code, which tells the printer to stop at that layer. Simplified 3D lets you do this quite easily with the help of a G-code script. Theoretically, you could also do this manually. I have added both codes inside the description of this video. They basically just pause the printer, move the printhead out of the way, and wait for you to resume the print. At your 3D printer, start the print job and make sure you have a soldering iron within reach. I would suggest using a thick tip and a temperature around 300 degrees Celsius. Also, you should use a cheap or already worn out tip, as it is going to oxidize very quickly because we don't add any additional solder. Wait till the printer stops, move the print bed into a comfortable working position, and then start pressing the wire into the plastic. The start and end point of the wire are going to create a weak point, so make sure not to place it right into the critical areas. Other than that, there isn't a lot to consider. Just follow the path and press onto the wire. Make sure to completely embed the wire into the plastic so that it's flush with the surface. Try to keep the amount of cuts as low as possible, so that in the best case you have one continuous wire. When you have finished embedding the wire, extrude some plastic manually to compensate for oozing, clean the nozzle and auto-home your printer. Lastly, just hit resume print in the printer's menu. And that's basically it for this video. If you have a great idea on which parts to use this technique, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and have a great day!